जय जगन्नाथ। आई एक्सटेंड माई वार्म ग्रीटिंग्स टू द फाउंडर ऑफ फ्यूजन फाइन आर्ट्स एकेडमी, द ग्रेट आर्टिस्ट असीमा मैम, फॉर ऑर्गेनाइजिंग सच ए ब्यूटिफुल एग्जीबिशन। आई वेलकम ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स इन दिस एग्जीबिशन। आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू नो दैट फ्यूजन आर्ट एकेडमी डूइंग सच ए वंडरफुल जॉब by creating various platform to promote the fine arts and encourage young talent in this field of fine arts. Art and artist are very close to my heart. I am also a performing Odissi dance artist. I extend my sincere good wishes to success of this event and looking forward to stay associated with you all.
वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभः निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। विद द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ लॉर्ड गणेशा वी वुड लाइक टू वेलकम यू ऑल टू आवर फर्स्ट फ्यूजन वर्चुअल आर्ट एग्जिबिशन बाय फ्यूजन फाइन आर्ट्स एकेडमी। वी आर ग्लैड टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ इट एंड वुड लाइक टू थैंक मिस असीमा फॉर गिविंग अस दिस प्लेटफॉर्म to showcase our talent. We hope you enjoy this show. Art enables us to find ourselves and lose ourselves at the same time. It expresses emotions or is an expression of life. When we hear the word art, what comes to our mind? Is it a painting, a sculpture, or a decorative piece? But friends, the meaning of art is actually much larger. If we talk about the literal meaning of the word art, it comes from the Latin word ars. It means practical skill. In Hindi, we say kala. Kala has come from the Sanskrit word kal. Kal means beautiful. So art is a highly diverse range of human activities engaged in creating visual, auditory, or performed artifacts that expresses the author's imaginative or technical skill and are intended to be appreciated for their beauty and emotional power. Art is the oldest subject of mankind, even before the development of any civilization or language or paper. There was art on the walls of the caves. Earlier, art in India was called as Shilpa. In fact, dance was also considered as Shilpa. But later in the 5th century, a scholar wrote, Sahitya Sangeet Kalavihin Sakshat Pashu Puch Vishan Vihin Trunam Naikhadyampi Jeevaman Tadabhagadeyam Param Pashunam, which means any person who does not have the knowledge of literature, music or art is not more than an animal, just the difference of horns and tail. One thing we find very clearly with this shloka is that art is different from literature and music. Means from here onwards, art is called as kala in India. There are two major literary work written in India in and around the 3rd and the 5th century AD, which talks about the fine arts in detail. One is the Bharat Muni's Natya Shastra. This book is about theatre, but it talks about art also. And the second book is Vishnu Dharmottar Puran. It is actually a part of Vishnu Puran. In this book, in chapter 35 to 43, Chitra Sutra is the oldest text that talks about fine arts in detail. The shloka, Kalanam Pravaram Chitram Dharmartha Kama Mokshadam Mangalya Pratham Datyade Gruhe Yatra Pratishthatam, means fine art is the key main among all the arts. One can achieve dharma, artha, kamartha and moksha through this. The home where art is praised is blessed than others. The art that we study is the visual arts, as it is clear that the art which we can visualize, see, is called visual arts. It has three branches in it. One is the 2D art, which has painting, sketching, done with different techniques, different materials, like oil painting, watercolors, etc. The other branch is sculpture. This is also done with different materials like wood, stone, metal, etc. They have different types in it, like full, solid sculpture or a hollow sculpture. And the third type is the architecture. This is also a type of an art. Fine art movements have reacted to each other both intellectually and aesthetically throughout the ages. Introduction of conceptual art and postmodern theory, practically anything can be termed as art. The fine art represents an exploration of the human condition and the attempt to experience a deeper understanding of life. The beauty of art refers to an interaction between lines, colors, texture, sound, shape, emotion, and size that is pleasing to the senses. I conclude it by saying, the paintbrush is becoming as powerful as the pen to express oneself. Play it with the colors, let the spectators be speechless. The entire Acropolis has become a painting of yours, future. You have replaced the strokes of your art with your colors. The melody does the sky, still resounds about you. An artist never dies, they are immortal. The fragrance is still fresh and will remain the same. Thank you.